A smoke alarm is a self-contained device that detects the presence of smoke and produces an audio or visual signal to alert of a possible fire. Alarms may be battery-operated or hardwired. While conducting NSPIRE inspections, look for smoke alarms in the inside and unit inspectable areas. Ensure that both NSPIRE and local code criteria are met during your inspection. While inspecting inside, ensure that smoke alarms are installed on each level of the building, as well as outside and inside any classrooms present. In the unit, check that smoke alarms are installed inside and outside each bedroom. Smoke alarms installed outside of the bedroom must be within 21 feet of the bedroom door. If the bedroom is separated from an adjacent living area by a door, a smoke alarm must also be installed in that living area. Additionally, confirm that an alarm is on each level of the unit. Smoke alarms on the wall must be between 4 and 12 inches from the ceiling, and more than 4 inches from the wall if mounted on the ceiling. In the kitchen, ensure alarms are installed at least 10 feet away from cooking appliances. Also, check that no alarms are placed where wind or draft openings could interfere with its operation, and that the alarm is not painted or covered by decorations or another covering. In some cases, one smoke alarm may fulfill a few requirements simultaneously. For example, a smoke alarm installed in a hallway outside multiple bedrooms would meet the requirement of outside each bedroom, as well as an alarm on that level of the building. To see examples of smoke alarm placement requirements in different building types, see NFPA 72. Access a free read-only version on NFPA's website. Inform the owner or participant that you are going to test the alarm, which will cause a loud sound. Push the test button for a few seconds. Watch for the alarm to flash or change pattern, and listen to determine if the alarm is loud enough to alert of a possible fire. Note, only fail an alarm that does not flash if it is designed to flash, as some alarms only emit a loud screeching sound. If the unit is occupied by a hearing-impaired person, all smoke alarms inside the unit must be designed for the hearing-impaired, so ensure the alarms emit sound and flash lights. If an alarm is not installed where required or is not functioning appropriately, it fails. Note, a combination smoke and carbon monoxide alarm should be evaluated under both the carbon monoxide alarm and smoke alarm standards. If a test button is not present or you are unable to test the alarm, ask the owner or participant for a smoke alarm maintenance certificate. Make sure it is dated within the last 12 months. If there is not a certificate or it is outdated, cite a deficiency. Note, by December 29, 2024, NSPIRE will comply with all NFPA 72 standards. Check HUD's website for more information on these statutory changes. For every NSPIRE standard, review the health and safety determination for each deficiency. As a best practice for the HDV program, photograph life-threatening or 24-hour deficiencies for the inspection report. For more details about inspecting smoke alarms and other inspectable items, review the NSPIRE standards on HUD's website. To see more NSPIRE inspection videos and other training resources, visit HUD Exchange.